Identifying computers in your infrastructure that are missing security patches can be difficult. If you only had one or two to deal with, it would be easy. You just walk over to the machine, log in, check for updates, next, finish, everything's done. But if you've got 10, 20, 30, 500, 10,000 of these machines, then deploying patches, although it is not incredibly complex, can have a very, very large scale. So let me show you how to automate a whole bunch of that with SolarWinds Patch Manager. In this scenario, we're going to look at computers that are missing patches. So in the Patch Manager console, I'll go to Enterprise, Update Services, my WSUS server, computers and groups, and all computers. This view has already been filtered for status of needing patches and third-party patches specifically. And if I just take one of these at random, this Core Tools 01, it needs 4 patches. And if I go down here to update details, you see all the patches here that are waiting to be deployed. Now this is fine if you want to find a specific machine that's missing 5, 10, 15 patches and send those patches directly to that machine. But let's say you have something new, like, 7-Zip has a new patch for some type of security flaw. So you want to go ahead and send that to a whole bunch of machines. Let me show you how to do that. From the update details, we see that the 7-Zip patch is actually a classification of tool. So we can actually go to our update management wizard, download and install all needed and approved security and critical updates. Now that's a great starting point, so we'll go ahead and start there. Now what I want to do here is I actually want to add another rule. So let's say we're currently patching for the security updates, and we're currently patching for critical updates. I want to add tools to this as well. So I want to do that as a classification rule and include tools. Then click Next. We have lots of options here. Before the update, we can reboot the machine. After it, we can reboot. We can run scripts before and after, whether they are remote scripts or local scripts. We can have approvals, so only include things that have been pre-approved. We can use the Microsoft online catalogs, lots and lots of settings. But for the sake of this demonstration, we're just going to go ahead and say finish. And that's it. So right now, the way this is built, it'll actually apply to all computers matching the criteria. So I can just go next. Optionally, I can schedule this out for another time, save reports, email reports of everything that's been completed. And that's it. Click finish, and it's done. So you can see with just a few clicks, you can choose what patches to deploy, what scale in which to deploy them, whether that's every computer and infrastructure, or only to specific machines. Like if you have a security tool that's out there and it's only on your web servers, you can send it just to the web server group. Or if you just want to send your critical patches out, you can send just your critical patches out, and you can do it to staging locations or your entire infrastructure. This is just another way that Patch Manager helps you make sure your systems are secure by keeping all your patches up to date.